everyone. Hey, starting the show off on a sad note. This is the saddest note that I think we've ever had to start bearing song of the day with. Folks, 13 folks, 13 well-known folks have lost their lives. Of course, there's others that have lost their lives. We know that happens every day, but my goodness, this year has been the absolute worst year ever for celebrity deaths. At least I think so. We got Blowfly. Remember him? Clarence Reed, phenomenal 70s musician. Very early pioneer rapper. Oh, yes. Clarence Reed, known as Blowfly, born February 14th, 1939. He passed away yesterday, January 17, 2016, 76 years old. This guy was a real icon. Pioneer X-rated rapper, folks. Oh, yeah. Before gangster rap, this was the guy right there. Blowfly. Definitely a sad loss there. Just read about this one today. If you don't know who he is, you ever heard of Mott the Hoople? Huh? Very unique band, Mott the Hoople. Well, he was the drummer for Mott the Hoople. That's Dale Griffin, born October 24th, 1948. He passed away yesterday at the age of 67, much too young. He was suffering from Alzheimer's. Folks, Alzheimer's disease is just such a cruel and debilitating disease that unfortunately leads to a slow, miserable death. It's just, it's so painful to watch. And very, very sad loss. Dale Griffin, Mott the Hoople drummer. And that's him, older and bolder there, still jamming. I'm sure he's jamming in a better place now. And then we've got... Ow, I forgot the guy's name. Jeez. I got so many, I can't even keep track of them, folks. Daniel Dion, that's it. Daniel Dion, yeah, he looks familiar. Now, unfortunately, Celine Dion, her husband passed away from cancer back on January 14th. 2 days later, her brother Daniel passed away at the age of 59. Just the worst couple days ever imaginable for Celine Dion. No question about that. Losing her husband and then her brother. Daniel Dion passed away January 16, 2016. Like I said, 59 years old. In fact, he passed away on Celine Dion's husband's birthday, Renee Angelil, who passed away 2 days short of his birthday. My goodness. Heartbreaking. This one I forgot to mention the other day. Yeah, you know who he is. That's right. David Margulies, phenomenal character actor. Born February 19, 1937. Passed away back on January 11, 2016. He was 68 years old. And, oh, 78 years old, rather. At least he lived a little bit longer. He was most famous as the mayor in the movie Ghostbusters. But for those that love their mafia movies and shows like I do, yeah, he was Tony Soprano's lawyer, too, in The Sopranos. Definite, phenomenal character actor. Big fan of him. Now, here's a hero right here. I thought that all the original 29 Navajo code talkers passed away, but there were many others, including this legendary man right here. The Navajo code talkers, they really, really damaging to the enemy. Because they were talking in code. And this man right here, Ernest Yazhe, Y-A-Z-H-E, born May 5th, 1923. He passed away January 12th, 2016. Ripe old age and 92 years old. So thankfully, he lived a good long life. Ernest Yazhe, incredible patriot. And the stuff that he did, a World War II veteran and hero. And then, no worry, folks. We got more coming. This is, like I said, this is unprecedented. I can't even begin to fathom the amount of losses we've had this year. This is probably the biggest of them all, folks. This one just happened. Glenn Frey. We all know him. We all love him. We all love the Eagles. When you think of American music, 70s music, you better believe the Eagles. Founding member of the Eagles, guitarist Glenn Frey, passed away after fighting a courageous battle for the past several weeks. He succumbed to complications from rheumatoid arthritis, acute ulcerative colitis, and pneumonia. Only 67 years old, born November 6, 1948, passed away today, January 18, 2016. That is a devastating loss for the Eagles and for all of us. And then our next unfortunate loss, I just caught this one. Growing up a big wrestling fan and still a wrestling fan, I remember this guy well. Iron Mike Sharp, the pride of Canada. Considered, or as he called himself, Canada's greatest athlete. Iron Mike Sharp, a big guy. Primarily an upper-level jobber in wrestling. I always felt he should have been pushed more. Most famous for his forearm. In fact, my brother and I wrestling as kids, I used to always use that Iron Mike Sharp forearm. Iron Mike Sharp, he was born October 28, 1951. Sadly passed away only 64 years old, January 17, 2016. I really liked him in the 80s and early 90s. Iron Mike Sharp, a good heel wrestler, a solid wrestler, and definitely a sad loss. In fact, he was wheelchair bound due to injuries for the years. Now, Johnny Bach, B-A-C-H. Johnny Bach, thank you, Kevin Sherman, for letting me know about this one. Former Bulls assistant coach, Johnny Bach, passed away today. He was 91 years old. Defensive-minded assistant under Phil Jackson during the Bulls' first three-peat after joining the team in 1986. Returned to the Bulls in 2003 after stops in Charlotte, Detroit, Washington. Retired in 2006 at the age of 81, 82 years old. Spent 18 seasons at Fordham University from 1950 to 1968. Winning record 265-193. Led the Rams to a pair of NCAA tournaments and five NIT berths. Spent nine seasons at Penn State, five winning seasons with the Nittany Lions. And then before joining the Bulls, coached the Golden State Warriors on an interim basis in 1980 and full-time 1983 to 86. Also an assistant on the 1972 U.S. Olympic basketball team, which advanced in the gold medal game against Russia. This guy did it all, and he did it in both college and NBA. A total success. Johnny Bach, born July 10th, 1924, passed away today, ripe old age of 91 years old. And then we've got, yes, I know Renee Phillips, you love the show, I love the show, bachelor father, and wonderful actress she was, Noreen Corcoran. She was born October 20th, 1943, passed away January 15th, 2016, 72 years old, bachelor father, and then later, in a bikini movie in 1965. Yeah, baby. And wonderful actress. A sad loss indeed. John Denver's guitarist. Yes. Pete Hutlinger. H-U-T-T-L-I-N-G-E-R. Try saying that fast a few times. Pete Hutlinger. Much too young of a loss. Born June 22nd, 1961. Passed away January 15, 2016. Guitarist for not only John Denver, but also Leanne Rimes. Love that guitar right there. And I believe cancer took him away. I can't even remember, to be honest with you. And then, yep, that guy. Another good one. Richard Libertini. We loved him in the movie Fletch. Yep. Born May 21st, 1933. He passed away back on January 7th, 2016. Yep. Actor in Fletch, most famous role, among others. A sad loss indeed. Richard Libertini. Definitely will be sorely missed. And then, this guy. Hang on. Yep. That guy, another icon. Can't even find him. Folks, I'm looking. This is how much. Oh, yeah. The Robert Banks Stewart, of course, of Doctor Who. He was the writer for Doctor Who. And he was born July 16th, 1931. He passed away January 14th, 2016. 82 years old. Well, I'm sorry, 84 years old, rather. So he lived a fairly long life. When you're trying to read notes like this, because of all the deaths, it makes it very difficult, my friends. It really does. But yeah, Doctor Who, there's a lot of you fans of Doctor Who out there, so heck yeah. And then, for you, Justin Dimmitt, this man right here, and all you Colts fans, Ravens fans, like my man Dennis Guido Guidus, you know him, you love him, Ted Marchibroda. Only head coach that I know of who coached not only the Baltimore Colts, but the Indianapolis Colts. He was also Baltimore Ravens' first head coach ever. And in fact, I know people aren't going to like this, but Bill Belichick broke down emotionally talking about Ted Marchibroda, because back in 1975, it was Ted that gave 22-year-old at the time Bill Belichick his first coaching gig when he hired him with the Baltimore Colts back in 1975. So yeah, he mentioned he owes Ted Marchibroda for his coaching success. Ted Marchibroda, born March 15th, 1931. He passed away January 16th, 2016. 84 years old. A definite icon. And definitely a sad loss indeed. So folks, 13 legends passed away today. And I'm sure there's others out there. I know there are. So folks, a big moment of silence, please, to all that have passed. And remember to always enjoy life every single day. All right, folks. Well, the show's got to go on. You know that. These guys wouldn't have it any other way. Neither would you. So hang tight. Be right back. That's right, baby. Hello, everyone. It is indeed Monday, January 18th, in the year of our Lord, 2016. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. Hey, there may be Monday, but it's only four more days to you. Thinking ain't Friday. That's right. Because you know beer is good for you. You hot diggity dog damn right it is. And today is National Winnie the Pooh Day. Because Winnie the Pooh creator, A.A. Milne, was born this day in 1882. And he passed away in 1956, so there you go. National Peking Duck Day. Eat yourself some duck, folks. And then the most important one of them all, no question about it, I am a huge fan of this man. His message still lives within me every single day. Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day, that's right, folks. Back in 1986, became a federal holiday for the first time ever. Sadly, it took to the year 2000 for all 50 states to buy in. But about damn time they did. Sadly, my wife had to work today. Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., a true icon, a man who was all about peace and harmony for all races. Absolutely. And rest in peace, Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. He was actually born January 15th, 1929, and assassinated April 4th, 1968. So, 30 years ago today, federal holiday, Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day, third Monday of January every year. All right, folks. Wow, beer is good for you. And,
beer is good for you. Darker light, it's brown as honey. Where this golden gold or money? Oh, baby, that beer is good for you. Use your tongue to tingle and your mind to buzz and wake up in the morning with a mouthful of fuzz.
Oh, trying to find my next spot there, okay. Alright, today's unofficial sponsor of our show. We're already 13 and a half minutes into the show. This is insane.
Beer is good for you.
Today's unofficial sponsor of our show. Our good friend Felicia Polifka's phenomenal photography business, Special Pixels. Yeah, baby. She's a phenomenal photographer. She calls herself an intermediate photographer who just loves taking pictures. Well, I'll tell you what. She is fantastic with her pictures. She really is. Try to find some samples real quick.
Beer is good for you. I said that beer is.
She just redid the page, so she's working on getting more on there. You'll see. Special Pixels, 259 followers. We got to get her up to 300 folks. And she's a phenomenal photographer and an absolute sweetheart. You'll understand. Felicia, you reek of exquisite, wicked awesomeness, my friend. No doubt about that. All right. Well, with that said, I am parched, and I want to give my man, Dennis Beach, a standing ovation, and I've got the salute! Oh, hell yeah! My neighbor, my fellow compadre, he's a big-time, wicked, hardcore New York football Giants fan, but hey, he's pulling for my Patriots. What a good neighbor. Like State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there, right? There you go. Well, anyway, He gave me this for free. Guinness West Indies Porter. And I know my man Justin Dimmitt over at Prosper is drooling right now. Justin, I'll let you know how this is in just a moment. This stuff is 6% alcohol by volume. Above average in strength. Of course, it's out of Dublin, Ireland. Phenomenal stuff. And I'm excited. I can't wait to drink this. Never had this one before. West Indies Porter. Oh, yeah. How about the Blues Monday beer consumption apparatus? That's right. Proper winning apparatus, proper technique. Here we go. And Mexican meatball stew for dinner tonight, known as albóndigas. Ever heard of it? Oh, that stuff's amazing. It's a mouthgasm, folks. Trust me. 45 degree angle right in the beer consumption apparatus. Right off the keyboard because I'm sad. Damn, gonna have a spill drop yet. Never have. Never will. This show's definitely going over 30 minutes today. Hell, it might even go over 40. I don't know. I hope not. Cheers to beer to all of you Prussians in Germany, goodbye, as they say in Japan. Oh. Oh, that's good. That is good stuff right there. That is a big solid A. Awesome stuff. Dennis, you rock, brother. Thank you so much. Oh, by the way, Dennis, I went ahead and bought that 18 pack, the same one that you bought. So if you want your beers back, let me know and I'll give them to you, okay? Well, come on over to Cost of the Love Goddess, and I got plenty of other choices. I got over 100 different varieties in the fridge, okay? So, yeah, let's drink. That's sad. Nearly 16 minutes on my show before I even took my first sip of beer. That's got to be some kind of record. All right, folks. Well, we have a bunch of birthday shout-outs. In fact, we got one from 2 days ago. I overlooked a few yesterday's show, but it's all good. How about my friend Jessica Peters? Back on January 16th, she celebrated her birthday. She's the final sitting grader of Martha Vineyard Regis High School class of 1992 with my brother. And Jessica, I saw you on the old Facebook now. Sent your friend request. I hope you accept it. I haven't heard from you in over 2 decades. I'd love to hear from you. Always got along with you great in school. An absolute sweetheart. And Jessica, happy birthday. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. January 17th birthdays. I cannot believe I missed this one on my show. A very dear friend of mine, sadly no longer with us physically, always with us mentally. My good friend Leanne LaCascio. Leanne, my dear, I know you're celebrating in a better place, and I'm sure you had a wicked awesome birthday yesterday. Don't worry, we all celebrated down here yesterday. We had a wicked awesome time. Of course, Leanne's a former real baby today on Beer and Song Today. Love that girl. Love you, Leanne. Love you. Love your family. Love Remy, your awesome husband, widow. And Leanne, miss the hell out of you. Happy birthday from yesterday. Hope you had a wicked awesome day. Hey, party hard and enjoy some more, right? Hell yeah. Cheers and beers to you, my dear. Next on the list from yesterday, my friend Edwin Otney. Now, Edwin, I just added recently on the old Facebook because we're big-time, wicked, hardcore, legit, no-bull Twilight Zone fans. Hey, hell yeah, buddy. And Edwin, happy birthday from yesterday. I hope your birthday was phenomenal. And I hope you lived it up, had a good time. I know I celebrated yesterday. You know it. Oh, I celebrated all weekend. And now, my Patriots are going to play the Denver Broncos in Denver. But anyway, I digress. Edwin, if I'm not mistaken, you're a Patriots fan too. If I'm wrong, you let me know, okay? Well, happy birthday, my man, from yesterday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. And celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. And the final birthday from yesterday goes to my good friend, Lisa Ratcliffe. Longtime friend of mine on the old Mafia Wars. An absolute sweetheart of a lady. And Lisa, happy birthday from yesterday. I hope you lived it up, had a lot of fun, and celebrated in style. I wouldn't have it any other way. Neither should you. But hey, happy birthday, my friend. And by golly, a big cheers and beers. All right. With that said, we've got today's birthday shoutouts. And there's a plethora of them, folks. There are. So let's get ready to rumble! All right. Terri Lindtall. Terri, an absolute goddess, a former real babe of the day on Beer and Song of the Day, who I met through our good friend Jennifer Conley over at Jen Conley, among others, and Jessica Monahan. The whole crew in Wichita, Kansas, You, my friend Terri, you're amazing, and happy birthday to you, and I hope you're living it up and have a lot of fun. And if you want to be featured as a real baby today on Beer and Song of the Day again, hit me up. We will make it happen. That is a promise. So happy birthday. Hope you have an awesome day and celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you, my dear. Next on the list. He celebrated a milestone birthday today. A badass, hard-working man, Jim, I work with down here in Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma, pretty much the same damn state. My man, Dalton Kane. Oh, yeah. And Dalton, you better be raising some cane tonight, because guess what, buddy? 21, lots of fun. You need to get your drink on as long as you're not driving. Hey, don't be stupid, though, all right? Don't raise too much cane. Don't go getting arrested and deported, all right? Well, Dalton, my man, happy milestone birthday to you. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard, enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969, minus the acid. And cheers and beers to you, my friend. Next on the list, my man Ken Smith. Ken, fellow mafioso, that's right, mafia was. And Ken, happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're having some fun. And be on the Mafia Wars shortly. Ice and fools, crushing skulls, doing what we like to do. It's a lot of fun. But Ken, happy birthday, my man. And a big cheers and beers. Next on the list, I didn't forget you, Jeff Sorensen. Told you I wouldn't. Hell yeah, you want to make sure you got a shout-out? Damn it, it's your birthday. Of course you're going to get a shout-out. Why? Because you're like Smith Barney. You made it the old-fashioned way. You earned it. Jeff Sorensen, an absolute badass leader of men, women, and nets that I worked with down here in Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana. Jeff, brother, I miss working with you on the job site. Great times. Hell yeah, working on the night shift. On the night shift? Oh yeah. Brother, it was fun. It was a lot of fun. You and I are now doing different things. It's epic. It's phenomenal. And boy, oh boy. You know something? I don't really miss it either. Do you? Probably not. You seem happy. I'm happy. Jeff, Mr. Hell are you, buddy. Great hearing from you. Happy birthday, my man. And celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, my man Mark Zaldos. Oh, yeah. Mark, wasn't it just last year when you celebrated with your first legal adult beverage? My God, where'd that year go, huh? Mark, you legendary badass engine repairman I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Northern Mexico, pretty much the same damn country. Happy birthday to you, my brother from another mother. And what's going on with you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're living it up, having a lot of fun. So, hey, do what I'm doing right here, right now. Party hard, enjoy. And a big cheers and beers, Mark. All right. Next on the list, my good friend Ciske, Snoke, S-N-O-E-K, Ciske, C-I-S-K-E, that's right, fellow mafioso on the old Mafia Wars, and Ciske, what's going on with you? I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Great having you in the Mafia Wars crew. We have a lot of fun, because teamwork makes the dream work. That's what we do. We get stronger by helping each other out, so that we can crush the opposition. It's a lot of fun, but nobody gets hurt for real. And Ciske, happy birthday, and a big cheers and beers. And then, next on the list, the lovely, gorgeous, amazing Theresa Reinhardt. Theresa, the wonderful, wicked, awesome mom of my good friends Jennifer and Amanda. Incredible young ladies. Boy, were they raised by an incredible mommy. No doubt about it. And Theresa, I hope to God I get to meet you in person someday. You're amazing. You're awesome. Always love the positive attitude. And Theresa, happy birthday, my friend. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. And celebrate well. And enjoy. Cheers and beers. That went down fast. 7 minutes. Empty, or maybe 8 minutes, actually. Empty as the brain cells of an average Los Angeles Lakers fan. I brought reinforcements. Yeah, nice and simple right here. Good old Shock Top Belgian White, 5.2% alcohol by volume from good old St. Louis, Missouri, as they call it up there, Missouri. St. Louis, Missouri. A wonderful city without a football team now because Stan Kroenke's a douchebag. Yeah, he is. Greedy bastard. But anyway, enough of that. Positive, right? Positive. We had enough negativity already on the first 13 minutes of the show or whatever it was. So yeah, 5.2% alcohol by volume, just a smidge above average strength. Probably opening apparatus, proper technique. Here we go. This stuff truly is like a real, legit, no bull Belgian white. out of Belgium. 45 grand writing big. Something I press five for the keyboard. Because I'm just that damn going to have a spell drop yet. Never have. Never will. Ah! Cheers a bit to all you pro in Germany, Kapai, Saint Japan. Ah, it's so smooth and so delicious. You know, I know, it's better with an orange slice. I get that. I agree. It's still a big, solid, I give it an A-. It's an excellent beer. Alright. Next birthday. Working over at the good old Taylor County Tap House. An absolute goddess of a woe, man. I cannot believe, I can't even believe. You don't even look like you look under 30. You really do. Dawn Jason, one of the most wonderful waitresses you're ever going to meet in your entire life. Waitress, bartender, slash sweetheart. Dawn Jason, happy birthday to you, my sister from another mister. And how you doing? Hope you're doing well. That's right, an absolute sweetheart living down here. Yeah, Texas. Otherwise known as Eastern New Mexico. That's right, pretty much the same state. Well, Dawn, happy birthday, my friend. And great hearing from you. And a big cheers and beers to you as well. Wow. Ah. Next on the list. My good friend Barb Stevens. Oh, yeah. Barb, an incredible leader of men, women, and nets that I know from a jolly old England. And down here in Yeehaw, Texas. It's only 40% of the size of Alaska. Yeah, it's a cute state. Well, Barb, what an honor, a privilege, and a pleasure working with legends like you. Hell yeah. Barb, great hearing from you today. And happy birthday. You better live it up and party hard and enjoy. I know you wouldn't have it any other way. Neither would I. Live it up, girl. Cheer the beers to you, my dear. Hell yeah. Next on the list, my man Richard Proulx. P-R-O-U-L-X. This guy, longtime friend of mine on the old Mafia Wars, celebrating a milestone birthday today, huh, Richard? Hell yeah, buddy. And what's going on with you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Ain't heard from you in a little while. Love to hear from you. Drop me the line, let me know how you doing. So, hey, hope you celebrate it well. I'm going to celebrate with you. To the big milestone to you, my friend. Big cheers and beers. Twin brothers right here. That I remember the day these young men were born. Wow, I cannot believe it. 34 years ago today, twins. Joe Costa was born at 5 o'clock in the morning, and he was under 4 pounds. And then Willie Costa, 45 minutes later, and he was 5 pounds, 6 ounces. I'll never forget it, because they lived two houses up from us, Midland Ave, Vinnyham, Massachusetts. And I've watched these two wonderful young men grow up, and they're great young men. Joe Costa, Will Costa, you two are phenomenal. You two are very near and dear to my heart because I've known you since the day you were born. Yep, absolutely. And Joe and Will, always great chat with you two guys. Happy birthday to the two of you. Live it up. Celebrate it well. I can't believe it. It's been 34 years. Wow. Hell, I know you longer than 34 years because I remember when your mom was pregnant with you two. And I remember finding out when she had twins. Because, you know, your parents and my parents, very close friends, always have been, always will be. Man, Joe, Will, you guys freaking rock. Happy birthday to the two of you. It's fine out saying congratulations to Martha's Vineyard Regional High School class of 2000. Yeah, legendary class indeed, huh? You know it. Let's strike, shall we? Double time. All right. With that said, our next birthday shout out goes to my good friend, Alan Karsten. K-A-R-S-T-E-N. Alan, what's up with you, fellow mafioso? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're living up, having a lot of fun, and celebrating in style. You should be. I am. You should too. Got that right. I celebrate everybody's birthday every day. It's a lot of fun. Well, Alan, happy birthday, my friend. And a big cheers and beers to you. Next on the list, I know this wonderful sweetheart of a lady from jolly old England, Amanda Jolliffe, the wonderful, gorgeous, better half of my buddy, my man, Jeremy Jolliffe, better known as Jolly Green Jolliffe, because he's 6'6" and an absolute badass, juiciest posse member for life. That's right. And Amanda, I miss you. I miss Jeremy. And I hope Jeremy's spoiling you rotten as you celebrate your milestone birthday today. Awesome stuff. So, hey, drop me a line. Let me know how you're doing. I miss you too big time. And happy birthday. And hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers. Now, check this out, Amanda. Born the exact same month, day, and year as you is my good friend, badass crew dog that I work with down here in Texas. This is like a whole other country. And legally, they could become their own damn country if they so choose. My man, Quintin Moran, M-O-R-R-A-N. Quintin Moran, milestone birthday to you, my brother from another mother. What's going on with you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're having a lot of fun. Welcome to the new age bracket. Yeah, you know that test will help you out big time. Those numbers, believe me, makes the difference. So yeah, Quintin, brother, drop me a line. Let me know how you doing. Miss the hell out of you. Happy milestone birthday and a big hearty cheers of beers from the love doctor, Reverend Dr. B over here. Wow. Let me double check. Make sure I didn't miss any birthdays. Because I'll tell you, I got notes all over the place. They just keep growing and growing. Like a politician's nose. The list just keeps growing. All right. Anniversary shoutouts. Yeah, we get a few of them. Back on January 16th. In fact, how ironic. Because that was the day that our New England Patriots beat the Kansas City Chiefs. That was a good game. Well, our good friends Adam and Robyn Schiadelli, a beautiful couple, an absolutely wonderful couple. Back on January 16th, they celebrated 14 years of exquisite, wicked, awesome marriage. I know them from jolly old England. Adam, Robyn, love you guys. Happy anniversary to the two of you. Hell yeah. Excuse me. And six more days. Let's hope to God we can beat Peyton Manning and the Denver Broncos in Denver. I'm scared. And you should be too. So hell yeah, let's make it happen. Adam, Robyn, happy anniversary to the two of you. Congratulations from yours truly, the love Dr. Reverend Dr. B. I miss you guys big time. And then, yesterday, our good friends Corey and his wonderful, gorgeous, better half, Jodi, got married 13 years ago yesterday. Got married January 17, 2003. Corey and Jodi Bolden, an incredible couple. And Corey, of course, big time wicked high core, legit noble, the Ohio State University fan. He's originally from Ohio. And Jodi, I think you're originally from Ohio too, aren't you? Ohio, the heart of it all. Well, you two are an incredible couple. And Corey, Jodi, you two, hey, miss the hell out of you. Always love chatting with you. And happy anniversary to the two of you. Your anniversary's a teenager now. Uh-oh. Ah, cheers and beers. And glad you two took my advice a long time ago and realized that Lucy's Burgers is the best burger joint in all of Yeehaw, Abilene. All right. I think we've got them all, folks, and I apologize. I will double-check the list later to make sure that I didn't miss anyone, because if I do... Oh, I did! I almost missed one. Back on January 18th in the year of our Lord, 1992, the day that my good friend Barb Stevens started her job, and Barb, you know what I'm talking about. That's right. Mama blowing a wrecking crew, baby. You should know. And our good friend George Seckman of Exotic Japan knows as well. Because that's right. He was there too. George Seckman and his wonderful, gorgeous, better half, Tomoko, they got married the day that you started your job, Barb Stevens, January 18th, 1992. They've been married for 24 years, living in Exotic Japan. And George, incredible guy. Tomoko, incredible lady. 24 years. Awesome stuff. Next year, silver anniversary special. Hell yeah! Well, shit! Kabai! As they say in Japan, happy anniversary to the two of you. Oh, yeah. Alright. Wow. Alright. I'm going to give shout-outs as I go along to a few more special folks. Because, see, folks, we had ourselves a trivia question. And it was a doozy. All right. What year was Martin Luther King did? What year was Martin Luther King Jr. Day first recognized as a federal holiday and celebrated on the third Monday of January? Well, my good buddy Mike Buds, who I've known for over three decades, this guy said it. He nailed it. 1986. Mike, you absolutely nailed it. Wicked awesome job. And a big, got a salute to you. Oh, hell yeah. Mike Buds, you'll appreciate this. That was wicked awesome. Or Michel Chenille, French for wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Canada, indeed. You gotta get some love to our neighbors up north, and I do that on Baron Song of the Day every single day of the week. Big and A. Mike Buds, big time Canadian heritage man, and brother, I drink to you. All right, folks. Well, guess what? That's right. It's that time. It sure enough is. It is indeed that time. It's time to announce this week's Fan of the Week winner. And folks, our Fan of the Week winner. In fact, something very special happened here. We have a legend. He's never won Fan of the Week before. So without further ado, it's time to bring to you. Our Fan of the Week winner for this week is our man Justin Dimmitt over at Prosper. That's right, facebook.com/LLAProsper. All one word. Go check him out and look at that picture. Thank you to our good friend Dan Butler. Dan Butler, an incredible man who's a computer genius. He created that picture. And Justin, I hit you up a few hours ago and let you know that, hey, by the way, you earned it. You deserved it. You won Fan of the Week. And Dan Butler hooked you up wicked fast. Dan Butler, you rock. Justin Dimmitt, you're the Fan of the Week winner. And I give you a hold up a salute. Oh, hell yeah! All right. Well, folks, with that said, something amazing happened. Yes, it did. Because, oh, shit! We had a tie! No kidding, we had a tie. Both Justin Dimmitt and this incredible man shared every single show, shared every single album, every single picture on Baron's Song of the Day. And, oh, by the way, they both brought fans of Baron Song today. I could not come up with a single decision. So I decided, and it's not the first time I've done this, co-winners. Tie. Two winners for a Fan of the Week. That's right, our man, George Sekman of Exotic Japan, and his wonderful wife, Tomoko. And, George, what's your daughter's name again? I forgot her name. There's a picture of you wonderful folks celebrating 2016, bringing it in Exotic Japan. George Sekman of Exotic Japan, you, my friend, Fan of the Week winner with Justin Dimmitt. Hell yeah! You earned it. You deserve it. Oh, yeah. Oh, big. I'll back a salute to you. Ooh, hell yeah. There you go. So we got ourselves co-Fan of the Week winners. Well, you better drink to that. You better recognize. Let's drink. All right. With that said, folks, we need to bring out our vehicle of the day, instrument of the day, pet of the day, and check this out. I not only have a real babe of the day, but I got a real hunk of the day on Baron's Song of the Day. If that ain't wicked awesome, I don't know what is. Folks, our babe of the day and our hunk of the day were both born in the exact same month, day, and year. It's absolutely incredible. They're both very near and dear to me. So here you go. My man CJ Clements. How about that? That's your Dodge pickup truck right there. Dodge truck. Beautiful truck right there for a wonderful man. Even though you're a New York Yankees fan, I still love you, buddy. CJ Clements, an absolute legend, an absolute badass member jammer. That's an absolute badass truck right there. So there you go. Your vehicle of the day on Baron Song of the Day. Hell yeah. And then our instrument of the day. Folks, check this out. It is Blues Monday. Don't forget that. And this guy's a real icon in the blues world. And I know my good friends, John and his wonderful guardian's better half, Rebekah Peterson. John's a big-time wicked hardcore, no legit no-bowl blues aficionado, and a big-time wicked hardcore, legit no-bowl Carolina Panthers fan, one of the legit ones out there. John and Rebekah Peterson, you know that guy? I know you do, John. Rebekah, do you know him? That's right, Blind Boy Fuller, an absolute icon. Born 1907, passed away February 13th, 1941, only 33 years old. Blind Boy Fuller, incredible Piedmont blues guitarist. This guy was awesome, and that's his wonderful guitar right there. Fantastic. It's just sad that they don't have any more pictures of him. But there it is, Blind Boy Fuller's guitar, your instrument of the day on Baron Song of the Day. A&A. How about our pet of the day, CJ Clements? I saw this. And how about that? There's your pussy. C.J. Clements' cat! Meow! Yeah, here, pussy, pussy. That's a cute kitty right there. We love our cats. We love our dogs. We love our pets. And C.J. Clements, your cat's awesome. Hell yeah. So instrument, vehicle, pet of the day. Let's drink. All right, folks. With that said, it is time for our real hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. And folks, this guy's a legend. He's a badass. And I'm a big fan of him. I've known him from jolly old England. I've kept in touch with him for years. An administrative legend. A very dear friend. A true friend. And a big time Boomer Sooner. That's right, my man CJ Clemens living in Wyoming now. That's right. Right down the road from my dear friend Lorelei De La Lune. Awesome stuff. And here you go, from March 5th, 1940, we bring to you Step It Up and Go, Blind Boy Fuller, on Blues Monday. An iconic song, an iconic man right there, C.J. Clements, a fisherman. There you go, and listen to that washboard. Hey, look at that, ladies and you men that love the men. This guy is single. No shit, he's single. It's a crime that you're single, C.J. Unbelievable. And the ladies love him. But yet, I don't know why, CJ, but you're available and on the market. Surrounded by awesomeness right there, family members. There you go. You know, there are celebrity birthdays for today. That's right.
Yes.
We've got Dave Bautista, WWE wrestler. Dave Bautista, the Pride of Washington, D.C. He's 47 years old today, Bautista. Phenomenal actor, Cary Grant. Oh, yeah, from a hunk of the day on Baron Song of the Day, Cary Grant. Born in the state 1904, passed away in 1986. Kevin Costner. How about that? Kevin Costner, 61 years old today. There it is. And like CJ, also a big-time sports nut and baseball fan. Great picture right there. Danny Kaye, or as Clark W. Griswold would say in Christmas Vacation, Danny effing Kaye. Yes, CJ's a big-time wicked hardcore Dallas Cowboys fan. Nothing wrong with that. He's legit. I can vouch for that. Danny Kaye, though, born in the state in 1911, passed away in 1987. CJ, I know it's Halloween. I know you're dressing up cool. But who's that girl with you? She's a cutie. Wearing a flamenco dress? Wow. How is she not with you and your awesomeness? I don't understand that. Jonathan Davis of Korn. I met him in person at a Los Angeles Erotica Porn Convention years back. He's a cool dude, a short little bastard, and a good dude. Jonathan Davis, really cool guy. 45 years old today. Oliver Hardy from the legendary comic duo Lauren Hardy. Oliver Hardy, born in 1892, passed away in 1957. Also a fellow Masonic brother. How about that there, Justin Dimmitt? Ted DiBiase, wrestler, badass. Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase, 62 years old today. A.A. Milne, already mentioned. Winnie the Pooh, born in 1882, passed away in 1956. Julius Peppers. Oh, yeah. I still think of him with the Carolina Panthers. And then he went to the Chicago Bears. Stop Bears. Where the hell is he now? Maybe he went to the Panthers. Hell, I don't know. Julius Peppers bounces around nowadays. Legendary defensive end, Julius Peppers, 36 years old today. There you go. Speaking of legends, about CJ. Oh, yeah. Uncle CJ, awesome guy. David Ruffin, phenomenal voice for the Temptations. Born this day, 1941. Sadly, passed away much too young at the age of 50 in 1991. David Ruffin, an incredible icon. Mark Messier, you want to talk about incredible icons. There's a guy who was overshadowed by Wayne Gretzky, but phenomenal NHL center, Mark Messier. Born in this day, 1961. He is 55 years old, NHL Hall of Famer, an absolute icon. And finally, Brett Laurie, Major League ball player. Brett Laurie, L-A-W-R-I-E. He is 26 years old today. That's your celebrity birthdays for today on Beer and Song Today as we show off the incredible and real hunger today on Beer and Song Today. C.J. Clements. And C.J., I got to ask you, what's up with the Clippers jersey? Thought you were a Heat fan. Or are you just a LeBron fan? I'm calling your ass out, brother. I got to ask. Because I don't deal with... I know you're a legit Boomer Sooner fan. There's no doubt about that. And I know you're a legit no bull Dallas Cowboys fan. And I know you're a legit no bull New York Yankees fan, as much as it pains me. And I got to give you credit. You finally got interested in hockey. You took my advice. You love hockey. And you've fallen in love with the Pittsburgh Penguins, even though Cindy Crosby has a better vagina than Hillary Clinton. Because Hillary Clinton has a bigger penis than most men. Ugh. But anyway, with that said, CJ, I'm glad you found a hockey team. And I told you, hockey is kick-ass. It's awesome stuff. Me being a Boston Bruins fan, of course. Hey, I'm a masshole. What do you want from me? I stick with all my home teams. But you've lived all over the world. I'll give you that. That's fair. So that's why your teams are scattered about. Just like the brain cells of an average politician, they're scattered all over the place. So, hey, check this out. CJ with another former Real Hunger Today on Beer and Song Today, my man John Hurt, who we know from Jolly Old England. That's right. CJ and John together. If that ain't wicked awesome, I don't know what is. CJ, who's that cute little young lady right there? Because she's pretty. She's finer than a new set of snow tires. So, there you go. That's your Hunger Today on Beer and Song Today. Let's drink. All right, time for our babe of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. And this wonderful, gorgeous, sweetheart of a lady is a former real babe of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. And we're featuring her again. She is our photographer. That's right. Special pixels. Uh-huh. Felicia Polifka. Born the exact same month, day, and year as our good friend CJ Clements. And CJ, like you, she's single. I don't understand it. Because she's drop-dead gorgeous. She's finer than a new set of snow tires. And an amazing young lady indeed. In fact, we're going to play a good song for her. And it's from 1939. With a little bit more Blind Boy Fuller. The song is called I Want Some of Your Pie. From July 12th, 1939. And she's wicked fine. Felicia Polifka. You're hot, real hot, damn hot. We're going to... Oh, it's a broken eye. Look at those eyes. Good God. Wow. See, even Sonny Terri agrees. And he's been dead since 1986. And he's whooping and hollering for you, Felicia. Yeah.
You got to give me some of it. Before you give it all of me.
Listen to them lyrics. She is beautiful.
I'm not bragging, but
honest day, just last year, a new world record is achieved by the United Kingdom's Lewis Clyde of Bristol. 16 years old, became the youngest person ever to trek to the South Pole. Honest day, 1998, my beloved Boston Celtics retired the Chief Robert Parrish's number 00. Love me some Robert Parrish. I always felt he was underrated compared to Larry Bird and Kevin McHale. The Chief was huge. Honest day, 1996. Baseball owners unanimously approved interleague play for the 1997 season. I think it was a fantastic move. I really do. Every other league they do it. Why not baseball too? Honest day, 1983. Finally, the International... Oh my God, look at that. International Olympic Committee restores Jim Thorpe's Olympic medals, 70 years after they were taken away from him for being paid $25 in semi-pro baseball. All damn time they returned his medals. He earned them. He deserved them. Every other country they do professional athletes, why not the U.S., you know? I want to say 1980, a phenomenal album, one of the greatest of all time. Pink Floyd's The Wall hits number one. I want to say 1975, Moving On Up to the East Side. A phenomenal spinoff from All in the Family, The Jeffersons, with Sherman Hemsley and Isabel Sanford. That show premieres on CBS television. That show ran for 10 seasons. It ran even longer than All in the Family, and it was a spinoff. Honestly, 1975. Wow, you're good. The $6 Million Man starring Lee Majors premieres on ABC television. Honest Day in 1973, my beloved Boston Red Sox signed Orlando Cepeda as the first player ever signed as a designated hitter. How about that? Honest Day in 1967, Yellowknife replaces Ottawa as the capital of Northwest Territories in Canada. How about that? About damn time. Ottawa, they're in Ontario. I think Northwest Territories deserve their own capital. Yellowknife, the birthplace of one Margot Kidder from Superman movies back in 1978. Honest Day in 1967, that was, I might add. Honest Day in 1966, Robert C. Weaver confirmed first black cabinet member in Congress. How about that? Secretary of Housing and Urban Development. Robert C. Weaver, African-American and cabinet member. Huge. Honest Day in 1965. Also huge. Especially for our British friends. The Beatles first appear on the Billboard chart with their famous 1963 classic song, I Wanna Hold Your Hand, as it hit number 35. Excuse me. Ain't she pretty? Felicia Palifka. Yep. Like you, CJ. She's single. And like you, born the exact same month, day, and year. Except the difference is, CJ, she's a hell of a lot better looking than you'll ever be. And you know that, and I know that. RSA 1958, the first black player in NHL history. About damn time. William O'Ree. Where? Boston Bruins, baby. That's right. My Boston Bruins signed the first black player in the NHL. And they thought we were racist. Sad thing is, our Boston Red Sox owner Tom Yawkey was racist. We signed a black hockey player before a black baseball player. We could have had Willie Mays. But no! Pumpsy Green. Red Sox were the last major league team to sign a black player. Not proud of that history, but folks, you learn from it. You learn from the bad, you learn from the good. You keep the good going gooder, and you forget about, you take the bad and drop it like a bad habit. And that's good right there. So don't ever drop that. Because that's beautiful right there. RSA 1951. NFL rather. Rules that tackles, guards, and centers are ineligible for a forward pass. Well, unless they're declared. New England Patriots are good like that. RSA 1948. The Ted Mack's original amateur hour begins on the Dumont Network, which no longer exists. It later went to NBC, CBS, and ABC. RSA 1933, the legendary White Sands National Monument in New Mexico, otherwise known as Eastern Arizona, is established. And that's our last picture of the day right there, the lovely, gorgeous, amazing Felicia Palifka. And on this day, 1930, 27 degrees below zero Fahrenheit, 33 below zero Celsius, Watts, Oklahoma. That's a state record. RSA 1912, a sad day indeed for English explorer Robert F. Scott and his expedition. They reached the South Pole. But they discovered that Roald Amundsen had gotten there before him. Yep. And then sadly, Robert Scott and his crew passed away in the South Pole. Frozen to death. That's a hard way to go. All I say is 1778, Captain James Cook stumbles over the Sandwich Islands. I don't know about stumbling over them. More like he discovered them. We found out that they were the Hawaiian Islands. All I say is 1777, San Jose, California, land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon, is founded. On this day in 1733, first polar bear exhibited in America. Where at? Boston, Massachusetts, baby. On this day in 1644, the first UFO sighting in America. It was by Perplexed Pilgrims in Boston, Massachusetts. They're like, oh my God, a UFO! Ah! Yeah. Hey, 1644, who knows? And on this day in 1535, Francisco Pizarro founds Lima, Peru. I'm sure it was probably already discovered, but hey, the first documented finding of it. So there you go. Let's drink a slam at home, shall we? Yep. Empty his brain cells of an average. Vote your own Canadians, Fanny. Well, folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, remember Dr. B. Folks, I'm in the feed as a head out. So everybody take out. We get awesome night and day. Peace be in the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive. You might spill your drink, or you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking or driving is dumb than being a Yankees fan. Ha ha, CJ. Don't worry, you're a lot smarter than the average. I promise you that. But what's number to that door is men's cyber women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people who watch on pets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports fans was a member of the Westboro Baptist Church or ISIS. Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big fat GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all on 2 for Tuesday. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye.